Sven Steinmann from the German Clothing Foundation is a patient man. And he doesn't mind his job, unpacking boxes of discarded clothing and blankets in the city of Helmstedt. But over the past 5 years, he's noticed a change. People now throw in all kinds of items that simply don't belong here.
A construction site warning lamp.
Clothing banks are increasingly being used as garbage containers. Perhaps a case of people not only having too many clothes, but too much of everything. So how has this happened? The cotton fields have traditionally been a key factor in the production and pricing of quality clothing. Global cotton production is on the rise, climbing 14% last year alone. Nevertheless, the proportion of textiles containing cotton has dropped. That's because of the growing overproduction of clothing and other textiles worldwide. Cotton is gradually being displaced by synthetic fibers, with the chemical industry eager to expand its share of the supply chain. As a quick glance around shopping zones in Germany confirms, synthetic clothing is all the rage. In addition to the low prices, it can cater to different requirements, being comfortable, durable, and breathable. An umbrella organization for clothing collectors in Germany is alarmed by the trend toward more and cheaper textiles.
Also in Deutschland werden jedes Jahr
Every year in Germany, 1 million tons of textiles are thrown away. That's the equivalent of a queue of trucks covering 1,000 kilometers. It's unrealistic to expect all that material to be used for people in need. We calculate that less than 10% is actually given to local charitable initiatives.
Für karitative und soziale Zwecke weitergegeben werden.
As for the other 90%, that's passed on to sorting companies, which later sell it on the world market. The price those companies pay has fallen in recent years to 300 euros per ton. 5 years ago, they were paying 400 per ton. Back then, the surplus of used clothes was not as excessive, and the quality was better too.
The proportion of poorer quality textiles, those which are no longer wearable, is rising. And the problem, especially with these low-quality items, is that they're often only partially recyclable, if at all.
If you believe the advertisers, people who want to look good don a new outfit every day. Wardrobes in many Western countries are bursting at the seams because clothes are cheap, or rather, in market speak, good value for money. And compliant customers duly take the bait. The profits of Primark, H&M, and other global retail chains are rising sharply, as are their share prices. And customers are wearing clothes for ever shorter periods of time. It's a classic consumerist cycle. Sven Steinmann from the German Clothing Foundation has reached the next collection point. This makes the one with the building site beacon look pretty orderly. So what's his impression of this container?
Von dieser Box, der Gesamteindruck?
Naja,
not so nice.
Naja, wir sind
I
halt
guess
eine
we're a throwaway society, sadly.
Ist leider so. Irgendwas riecht hier
schrecklich. Something smells a bit rancid here.
What does he mean by rancid?
It stinks like someone's thrown away their rubbish in here.
What was his most extreme experience so far?
Rotting food. With maggots. I've seen it all.
But poor hygiene is not the only problem facing the clothes collecting organizations. The materials have become noticeably thinner. Parcel donations help to compensate for the declining quality. People who send donations by post to the German Clothing Foundation tend to wash the garments beforehand. They seem to give more consideration to those in need. Nonetheless, it's becoming increasingly expensive to ensure the requisite quality when it comes to the bales of compressed clothes that eventually go for sale on the world market.
We have to sort through a huge amount just to get to the 4 or 5% of good quality items. Around 80% we can only sell to industry for use as filler material and use the income to finance relief aid projects.
But it's a system under threat. African markets, which for decades have provided new homes to German cast-offs, are becoming more selective. Uganda, for example, is making efforts to boost its own small-scale textile industry. That's one reason why the economic area, the East African Community, wants to halt imports of secondhand clothes starting next year. It's a move that many say is long overdue, but not everyone's applauding. After all, many consumers in countries like Uganda do benefit from access to used European clothes.
Zunächst einmal ist Secondhand für viele Menschen
for a lot of people, secondhand is the best option for getting quality clothes.
Secondhand
items are often cheap and good. Plus,
letztlich
trading them can also provide people with an income.
Auch Einkommen für viele Menschen.
Back in Germany, the flood of discarded clothes is not set to stop anytime soon. So German clothing recycler Soex is working with many major high street retailers that now take back used clothing. This means the stores can claim their businesses are more sustainable. And in the best case scenario, companies like Renewcell in Sweden recycle the clothes and turn them into a form of synthetic cotton. And the consumers? They get vouchers in return for their old clothes to put towards yet more new purchases from their favorite stores.